In our previous tutorial, we created a REST API to create a customer contact in Salesforce. Now we're going to create an API that will retrieve and update contact details in Salesforce. In the App Connect dashboard, click the Customer API tile. Click the Operations tab, then stop the API so that we can make changes. Click Select an operation to add, and select Retrieve Customer by ID. Then click Select an operation to add and select Replace or Create Customer with Filter. We're going to retrieve a customer by using an ID and then update a customer by using a filter that is based on the properties that we added for the model. In this case, the available filters are first name, last name, and email. For the Retrieve Customer by ID operation, click Implement Flow. Notice the request URL example. When we call this API, we will have to append the customer ID to the end of the URL to retrieve the customer details. Next, we need to define which customer details we want to receive in the response. Click Plus. Select Salesforce Contacts Retrieve Contacts. We want to retrieve contacts whose contact ID is equal to the customer ID that the user of our API enters, so we'll add this to the where condition. We'll leave the other fields with their default values. Click Response. We'll leave the status code as the default and map all the fields to the Salesforce Retrieve Contacts fields. For customer ID, select contact ID. For first name, select first name. Last name, then email. Ignore the warning messages. They won't affect the response because only a single contact that corresponds to the unique ID specified will be returned. Click Done. For the Replace or Create Customer with Filter operation, click first name and last name to deselect these properties as filters. Then click Implement Flow. Notice the request URL example and request body example. Click Plus. Select Salesforce, Contacts, Update or Create Contact. To uniquely identify the contact to be updated, we're going to update the where fields. So we'll select Email, then click in the field and under Request Body Parameters, select Email. Configure these Salesforce fields by mapping their values to those from the Request Body Parameters. For last name, select last name. First name, select first name. And for email, we can see that the value in the where condition will be used here, so we don't need to manually specify a mapping. Click Response. Leave the status code as 200. Now we'll configure the response body fields by mapping their values to those from the Salesforce Update or Create Contact fields. For customer ID, select contact ID. First name, last name, then email. Click Done and start the API. Now we're going to test the flow to retrieve a customer and then update the first name of the same customer. Click the Manage tab and then scroll down to Sharing Outside of Cloud Foundry Organization. We can see the API key and the API portal link which we generated to test the Create Customer operation in the first tutorial. Click the API portal link to open the API in an API portal window. Notice that the Customer Create option that we created in the previous tutorial is shown under Operations together with the two new operations that we've just created. Click the Customer Create operation. We'll invoke the Customer Create operation again. If you remember from the previous tutorial, we clicked Try It, generated some test customer details, removed the customer ID because Salesforce will generate this, then clicked Call Operation. Now we'll copy the customer ID value that was returned by Salesforce and paste it into a text editor. If we take a look at our contacts in Salesforce, we can see a new contact has been created. So we'll go back to the API portal and invoke the operation to retrieve a customer by ID. Click Customer Find by ID in the left pane, then click Try it. In the ID field, paste the customer ID value that you copied earlier. Click Call Operation. Scroll down to the response section. There's the success code 200 and the response body with the contact details that were retrieved from Salesforce. Copy the contact details in the response body and paste it into a text editor. To invoke the operation to update the details of an existing customer by using a filter, click Customer Upsert with Where in the left pane, then click Try it. In the data field, paste the contact details that you copied earlier, and then delete the customer ID line. Copy the email value in the data field, and then paste it into the email field. This value will be used to filter for a Salesforce contact with this identical email address. In the data field, change the value of first name property to a different name. Click Call Operation. Scroll down to the response section. There's the success code 200 and the response body containing the customer ID value, as well as the updated first name value and the unchanged email and last name values. So that's great. We've updated our API with two additional operations. Now if we go to Salesforce, we can see that the contact's first name has changed. Thanks for watching.